Hey guys, Stephen Cox here, and today I'm at Uke Republic, and we're going to be looking at the Kala Zebrawood U-Bass. So if you like videos like these, please hit subscribe below, consider becoming a patron, and visit ukerepublic.com for more of these things. So here are the specs of the Kala Zebrawood U-Bass. The top, back, and sides are all made of zebrawood. The binding is rosewood. The neck is mahogany. The fingerboard is walnut. The headstock is the standard headstock, but it's made of zebrawood. The bridge is walnut. The nut is the Graftec Newbone. The saddle is a composite material. The tuners are the custom black die-cast tuners. The strings are Aquila Thunder Black strings. The electronics are the U-Bass Active 3-band EQ with a built-in tuner. And with all the U-Basses, they include a padded gig bag. The scale length is 20 inches. The full length of the instrument is 29 inches. And this U-Bass has 16 frets. And I got these specs off of Kala's website, so you can find more at kalabrand.com. So let's talk about the pros and cons of the Zebrawood U-Bass. For the pros, it's fairly affordable. It has a $259 US price tag, which is very low for a Kala U-Bass. It's aesthetically pleasing. It has zebra wood, obviously, and a rosewood binding that actually looks really nice. It even has a little bit of a rosette. So to me, the price combined with the aesthetics make this a great value. And then also, as with all the Kalas in this new lineup, every fret played cleanly. There was no fret buzz due to the instrument itself. So now let's talk about the cons. The first con that I want to mention is just the normal one with every U-Bass, that the Thunder Black strings, as well as pretty much any of the polyurethane strings, are just a little bit sticky. So that stickiness causes a little bit of string noise, and your fingers kind of stick to the strings, which can take a little getting used to. But it's not a real con, it's just something that all the U-Basses share. And then with this particular model, the EQ, when set to flat, is slightly muddier than the Bamboo or the Wanderer was. So you may want to take a little bit of mids out, boost the treble a tiny bit, and you may want to take a little bit of low end out on this one, although you might not have to. Alright guys, that's it. I hope you've enjoyed this review today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel, and visit Uke Republic for more information on these bases.